front row. The back row finds Carson Allred, Andy Pate, Bailey Forrest, Dylan Rose, and Cody Flash. So that is the way that they line up. It is going to be quite a final.
A wild, woolly, technical racetrack, made even more complicated with the icy edges and rough spots underneath, and then the air itself saturated, so the riders and drivers having to deal with vision issues as well. It's a super challenge, but the Pro-lite riders are up to task, and we're about to send them on their way at the Elk River Snowcross National. Starting line from the middle. Looks like one of the Anderson sleds jumping out along with Anson Scheel. And we've got chaos up in the first turn as a couple of riders tip over their sleds at the front of the field. It's going to be the number 12 sled of Anderson.
That's Cameron Anderson out front. And then right behind him, Anson Scheel. Scheel, the number one qualifier. Anderson qualified eighth. So got a great hole shot. There you see the racers starting to work their way through.
Adam Peterson made the move on Anson Scheel at the end of the U.S. Air Force flyaway. So the winner one round ago, now up into the second position, setting his sights on the leader as we look from the back of Anson Scheel now running in third, and Travis Kern coming up there to give him a challenge as they blast over the Amsoil.
I was a little surprised at how wide Anson Scheel went there. Don't know if that was a handling issue because of the snow conditions or just decided to take that line, but we talked about how this racetrack has become so much one line, a lot of guys following each other. Now you see these racers who are starting to explore up front. Look at this. There's Kern in that shot, taking it, getting around Anson Scheel. So now Kern on the podium, Scheel on the outside, sitting in fourth.
Meanwhile, it is Cameron Anderson continuing to set the pace here as Kern gassing away here as they charge down off the Fox Shocks corner. Your leader, Anderson, powering back into the Polaris rhythm section. Adam Peterson, winner one round to go, still in second, but Kern, he's got a fast sled tonight. He is already reeling in Peterson.
Kern on the Cattoo Motorsports Polaris. Won one of its qualifiers. Travis Kern out of Aiken, Minnesota. Been a long time snowcross racer. On that 201 Polaris, trying to make up some ground.
Some different lines being taken there as Peterson stayed to the outside of the Ziegler cap backstretch. Kern elected to go up the left side of the inside. They're back down into the interior part of the track now, into that Ram Trucks rhythm section. And Kern continuing to put the pressure on, dives it into the berm and kicks off, but watches the snow dust coming up for Peterson, still about six lengths ahead of him.
That line didn't look as fast for him. I think when you go in deep like that sometimes, you just drove off so much speed that the racer in front of you, if they aren't going deep into the corner like that, they're able to scrub and carry a little more speed with them. So that's interesting. Here's Nick Lorentz. Lorentz trying to move his way up the race order as he's trying to move into fifth. He's currently sitting in sixth. That's Mitchell Thielen right ahead of him.
Yeah, he went way wide coming out of the Arctic Cat corner all the way out to the right side of the start straight. Fortunately, nobody else behind him to try to sneak to the inside. Maybe he was trying to build a little extra momentum as we watch him battle, and a triple in by Lorentz. He was doing that earlier, triples again.
There he's got his position, but look at Thielen trying to come back down underneath, but Lorentz able to carry just a bit more speed and was able to make the pass.
All for a better start for Nicholas Lorentz, and he might be challenging for the podium, except he just went off track.
Jumps back on, didn't better his position. Now he's got to do battle with Thielen again, and Thielen's going, no, not anymore.
Yeah, boy, did Lorentz get sketchy there, coming down off the jumps before the end zone finish line.
Watch the riding styles here. You know, watch Nicholas. Nicholas looks like he's just really pushing the envelope right on the ragged edge as you watch the drivers up front. Maybe a little bit smoother, but Nicholas trying to get on that podium, working ever so hard. It looks like he's just really overextending sometimes on certain parts of this racetrack. There he goes again. Makes contact. That's what I was talking about, man. You can only push so hard. After you push that's when bad things are going to happen to you and the people around you.
Still, Anderson leading by 1.7 seconds over Peterson, followed by Kern, Shield, Thielen, and Taylor Cole now up at 6. Lorenz is falling back to the 7th spot.
See, the snow dust starting to hang a little bit. I think that the visibility has improved. That, you know, we've seen that in the drone shot, the moisture not sticking to the lens quite as much, but still, snow dust a bit of an issue here on this big racetrack.
Adam Peterson, the winner, one round to go. Would love to make it another round win. He continues to put the pressure on
Cameron Peterson's last lap, 59.81. That's 2 seconds faster than what Cameron Anderson was. He's only about 1.7 seconds behind. Let's see if he improved that. Matter of fact, Anderson was able to put another tenth between the two. So even with that good lap the lap prior, Peterson still sitting in second place as laps starting to count down.
Working toward the completion of lap number 7 of this 9-lap Pro-lite final, Cameron Anderson, the point leader, looking to extend that gap here on the early part of the season if he can bring home the win in tonight's Pro-lite final.
But wouldn't that be something? Peterson going 1-1 here in rounds 1 and rounds 2. Levi Lavallee and Lavallee Racing have to be pretty happy with the finish for their Pro-lite rider, Adam Peterson.
And Travis Kern put in a good lineup with the two Motorsports Flying Racing sponsor, 201. He has the final spot on the podium right now, and about a 3-second gap between himself and Anson Shield, who sits in 4th.
What's that jump area again?
Just up the track, you can see how close Kern is getting to Adam Peterson here, and Blue Peterson got a little tilted in the air, was able to right the ship as they come through that Dennis Kern corner out to the U.S. Air Force flyaway. These two have about a lap and a half to go, battling for the final couple of spots on the podium here.
Kern really pushing too, trying to make some ground. He's on the podium, but Kern would sure like to get second place points here. It'd be a good finish for him and for two motorsports. There's your race leader, Cameron Anderson.
He'll launch down to the Amsoil finish line where the white flag is waving. And he took a look there, a hard look to the left to make sure he could see what flag that was.
Another driver that could be on the podium in both rounds 1 and 2 with a win here. He took second place in round 1. You'd have to think that would put him close, if not top, of the points battle here in the Pro-lite class. So a big, big race for Anderson Racing.
And here's that last lap battle for 2nd and 3rd. Peterson trying to hang on for a second place finish. Travis Kern putting in the work, trying to run him down here as they head towards the Fox Shocks corner. But Peterson able to get the power down on that Lavallee Racing Polaris, and he will be able to chin away and maybe lock down the second position. Here comes Cameron Anderson. He will take the checkers and the win in the Pro-lite final here at ERX Motor Park. Adam Peterson in for 2nd. Travis Kern comes away with the final podium spot. Cameron leaps right off the sled and gets congratulations from the mechanic down at the starting line area. You can see the emotion on Cameron Anderson. I don't think that sled even came to a full stop before he was jumping off for the big power hug. So congratulations to Cameron Anderson, getting his first Pro-lite final win of 2021. We'll hear from our podium finishers when we come back, and Amsoil Pro is on the way from Elk River, Minnesota.